Hello, I'm Dr. Andrew Neville. I specialize in treating adrenal fatigue and related chronic illnesses. And I want to talk to you today about why adrenal fatigue is not just adrenal fatigue and why that problem is the main reason why you might not be getting better even by seeing some of these adrenal experts who are out there. So the most accurate name to give this condition, it's not a good name either, but the most accurate name to give it would be to call it a stress response system dysfunction. Your adrenals are part of your stress response. Absolutely. They're the ones that are dumping cortisol and adrenaline. And cortisol and adrenaline, they get a bad rap from me, but you can't live without them, right? You don't want too much. You don't want too little. You need them kind of in that sweet spot, right? But the adrenals don't decide whether or not to dump cortisol and adrenaline. They're being told what to do. So if there's an adrenal issue, then, which you can almost see just from symptoms, right? Of course, you can test it. But if there's an adrenal issue, then there will be a problem with whoever's telling the adrenals what to do, which happens to be your pituitary and your hypothalamus. Now, these are endocrine glands, hormone-producing glands. They live in the brain. They tell the adrenals what to do, and there's crosstalk. They all talk back and forth. Now, I'm not talking about Addison's disease. Hopefully, you know that, right? This is a more subtle dysfunction. It's a communication disruption problem. But where there's adrenal problems, there's problems with the hypothalamus pituitary. But actually, those guys are just middle management. They're not calling the shots either. Now also, there's a whole other division of your stress response. So we've got this hormone division, which ends in your adrenals. We've got another division, which is nerves. Now these are the nerves, though, that control your organs. It's called your autonomic nervous system. And essentially, you've got two nerves, or wires is how they function, right? Two wires from the central nervous system, so from the brain, going to every organ. One is a fight or flight wire, the other is rest and digest. And the functions oppose one another. So you can only really flip one on at any one time. So tiger jumps out at you, boom, you wanna jump into fight or flight. And you don't wanna wait for the hormones to do it because that takes minutes, you'd be dead. So you need these wires, right? Like electricity, instantly crank up my heart, turn on that wire, turn on the wire to my lungs, turn on the wire to some metabolism, sugar, right? I need fuel, oxygen, and I got to pump it to the blood, the heart and organs, because I got to deal with this tiger. At the same time, we flip off the wires to other non-essential stuff, immune system issues, reproductive hormones, not so important, right? Digestion, shut those nerves off, right? So these, they oppose one another. Now, I tease these apart to learn about them and to understand where the symptoms are. Do you have palpitations? Well, that might be more of a nerve thing, right? Do you have a blood sugar problem? Well, that might be more of a cortisol hormone issue. So we can understand what's going on better. Also, treatment is different, right? Hormones are different than nerves, so treatments are different. Except these two systems work intimately together. They are entangled. You can't affect one without the other. But neither of those divisions calls the shots in your stress response system. The CEO of your stress response is a step up in the brain, this deep part of the brain, which is called your limbic system. The limbic system is a non-thinking part of the brain. It's a reacting part of the brain. It has a variety of regulatory kind of jobs, temperature regulation, sleep-wake cycles, appetite, hunger, some stuff like that. But it's also the seat of your stress response. Its job is to receive information, to interpret your environment, right? External environment, internal environment, through sensory, nerves, perception, through chemicals in the blood supply. It receives this information, has to then filter it through your past experience and through your belief system, and then it has to decide subconsciously, is this stimulus stressful, harmful? Can this thing kill me? Do I have to jump this body into fight or flight? Hormones, nerves. Or is it the opposite? Harmless, innocuous. I can just chill out and rest and digest and let it pass. And what happens with the limbic system over time, with chronic stress over time, is it gets trigger happy. It starts over-interpreting its environment as being stressful. a minor stressor doesn't generate a minor response anymore. It generates a major response. So it kind of cranks up the amplitude. And it's all in an effort to protect us, right? To save our lives, this subconscious part of our brain. This sensitization will also happen in the rest of the nervous system, but most notably the sensory nerves. So a lot of my patients will come into me and they're like, yeah, all of a sudden I'm sensitive to these bright lights and loud sounds and harsh chemicals and smells bother me now. Even touch, like touch, you know, you can touch one of my patients and their limbic system says, ouch, even though it's just touch. All those nerves are on red alert. And it's actually in order to protect us, right? Because your limbic system thinks you're, it's like you're living in the plains of Africa, hiding in the tall grass, being stalked by a lion. Well, you darn well want your system to become hypervigilant, right? You want your pupils to dilate so you can see. You want your ears to become hyperacoustic. You want to smell and detect. The faster you detect that lion, the better your chance of survival. Problem is, we don't live in the plains of Africa, which I imagine is pretty chill most of the time. We live in kind of a fast, quick-paced, toxic world, which is bombarding our nervous system, bombarding our limbic system constantly, which is keeping us wired for stress. So what happens is now we're overusing a system that was designed to be used once in a while and then turned off. Now we're overusing it and we're stuck in fight or flight all the time. Now I'm going to talk a little bit about why you should care about that in another video, but hopefully that explains the stress response system and why adrenal fatigue is not just adrenal fatigue, because you can't take a little vitamin C or a little ginseng and think you're going to fix all of this. But what you can do is you can treat the hormone side altogether, because there's other stress hormones besides cortisol. There's other stress hormones. You can treat the hormone side. You could treat the nerve side. You can even work on the limbic system. Now you have to hit it from a variety of angles in more of a kind of a holistic way. Again, there's no one magic pill that fixes all this stuff together. But you hit all this in a holistic way from a variety of angles, and you absolutely can rewire that stress response system. What that does is it takes you out of fight or flight, turning off the wear and tear, putting you into rest and digest, turning on the healing and repair. This shift is what heals people. Turning on your body's ability to heal itself, there's nothing more powerful. No pill does that. No practitioner, no therapist, nothing does that. Turn on your body's ability to heal itself, and your body takes care of the rest. That's the goal. And that's what absolutely can happen. So have hope. So hopefully this helps. For more information, you click a link down in the comments section below, and yeah, have hope. All my best.